tata wane lele ulele matita wane ulele ulele obona ya wane ulele ulele okosisi wane ulele onye na chugi na chuchigi ulele ojo koko mada ulele ulele wako kwa mweboso ulele ulele. Nobody do no banka. Nakuko body do no banka. Epa habaro. Audio to oke. Eza na chobuda. Aha ya bode buchi. Eza na oke. Ore po ndio bode ya. Ore po ha. Cha mambo en uro pimbuza. Zan 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 zan. Ah, oh, there's a woman up here.
Edima, mama, 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 mama,
Matakria Maramadiago Otto Kurukwe
Ezedia no no de muka kumarigwe. Winene bonyo gabu ileta na gimana na tineke. Kedo nye mana mayo mama. Maputi. Ara juri obi. Boko. Kurukwe. Winene na chota kampro baka. Nkebuna. Obonye kemare kema. Moji ye putari yebu. Na nwa mboga na kongu inene. Bonye nganga. Ni imo mara. Wadige kelepa madan chari chari.
Amen. Nete kwa derege. Le long prodi no burala. Eben dioru weli na nyahelu. Weho. Ebu benemwemu. Ima monye kasielu. Nandegeji mweru mwe. Nandisi wemozo. Eze bile weche. Kanye buabomu. Enye waleze ya. Kanye tiempomu. Aleluya. Aleluya. Otonu onye wany. Obiafra. Obiafra. Aleze chupono wa. Obiafra. Mberiga derere. Mberi. Oh mberi. Obidianyo to okolota. Aleze chubu nuwa Kanyi buabongu Kanyi tiempongu Nyonye wanyo tutu Emwe womeri Gazisa ozioma Nongu ebi ebi Aleluya Aleluya Ozayon marwama Obya Obiafra, ebo bibi uchineke. Mberi, oh mberi.
Biafra, aleze chineke nkano nuwa. Obodo nsọ nke Chineke, anyị na-anabata gị. Ozuzu oke nke izu oke nke Chineke, anyị hụrụ ịma mma gị n'anya. Ebe obibi nke Chineke n'ụwa, anyị na-ekwe nkwa idebe. Anyị na-ekwe nkwa idebe jite nke obi anyị ọcha. Ka anyị wee jere gị bụ Chineke ozi, ma fekwa gị ofufe nke ọma, na oke ike I nyere anyị. Ịhụrịta ibe anyị n'anya, na ihe ibe anyị tọrịta anyị ụtọ, n'ime udo, na ịdị n'otu na irubere iwu gị isi igirigi ngọzi zokwasị anyị oh
for the word. I thank God for his mercies for keeping us alive in the midst of the COVID-19 and all the sicknesses that happened or took place last year. We are happy that we are able to witness 2021. Just a day before yesterday, the Bimasol family had its second election. The election went successfully well, and the new executive members have been elected to take care of the affairs of the organization for 1 year. I'm happy. I thank the new executive members and thank members all over the world who participated in the general election of 30th December 2020. I'm very happy the way things are moving, and I'm very happy that many other Biafran groups are also doing well. most Biafran groups today believe in non-violence, which we have been advocating for the past 20 years. It is only through non-violence that we can be able to achieve Biafra faster. Notwithstanding, I learned that some criminal elements went to Ebonyi State and destroyed some property belonging to the Hausa community there. That's a cowardly act. These people do not know what we go through to sustain the peace that exists in the Southeast. These people do not know what we go through to ensure that the lives and property of our people in the North are safe. They don't know. They do all these shameful acts to create crises, just to create crises. These were people the government hired to dismantle the activities of MASO in years back. They are unable to do that. Today they are frustrated and try to cause havoc and crisis in Igbo land because of their frustration with the government, because they were unable to carry out their original assignment. This action should be condemned. I am happy that our friends in the North have understood the activities of these criminal elements. If it were in the past, the killing of our people would have started in the North with such actions of theirs. But because of how things are today, because of the understanding, their action was largely ignored, because everybody knows that they are acting under frustration. They are frustrated. People should toe the line of peace. People should toe the line of peace. There is nothing that is greater than peace. Whatever you are looking for, you have to observe the rules of peaceful engagement. That takes me to some people that are today clamoring for peace, trying to bring unity among the pro-Biafra groups. I have listened to them over time now, and some people have sent me their clips, the clips of their brokers. I've listened to them. I think they're making sense. I support the unity of all pro-Biafra groups. I support the unity of all pro-Biafra groups. I have listened to what they're saying. They're making sense. We must encourage one another. All pro-Biafra groups should exist in their groups. We complement one another. We don't have to criticize one another. Anybody that comes to criticize another group is the actual saboteur. If you are working for Biafra, you should see the next person in the other group as your brother. If you are working or talking against him or blackmailing him, it means you are a saboteur, because all of us are working for Biafra. So I support this group. I support Uchemefo and Obidi Obienu in their search for peace among the Biafra groups. I support them. Yes. Some people are saying soon they will start asking for funds and all that. They will ask people to contribute money for them. And so what? If they need funding, be myself. We support them. We are the grandmasters here. We are the big master, are the big brothers. We started the struggle before any other person joined. So we are playing the role of the big brother. If those advocating the unity of pro-Biafra groups need money, we sponsor them 100%. I repeat, 100%. As far as they are looking for peace and the unity of pro-Biafra groups, I can say today, for 20 years we've been in existence, nobody from anywhere in the world can say he has given himself one naira. I challenge anybody. If you know you have sent even $1 to Ralph Wazirike, please, you can say it anonymously. Don't show your face. Give details. Bring the receipts. Put it on the internet. So also, if any government, local government, state government, federal government, has given Ralph Wazirike $1, show it anonymously. Don't show your name. Don't show your face. Don't even put your name. Bring the receipts. Or even tell a story connecting such transaction on the internet. By any means, you can expose it. Say it without even showing yourself or putting your name. I challenge. We are on ground. Because over 20 years, we can carry out any assignment we want to carry. Just like some people are going to the bush and brandishing or showing the presence of less than 1,000 boys, the bush. It makes me laugh. If Bin Masol wants to showcase our security, then we know that what they are doing is a child's play. No place will contain our security. No place, no bush, no area, no state capital. We don't talk. What are we talking for? Playing to the gallery for what? We've been there for 20 years. There's nothing we can do today. We are just a country. Just like next month, or this next month now or so, this year, we are going to South Africa to play football as Biafrans. This year too, we are going to Hague to represent Biafra. So it's not a big deal because we've been there. We have the resources to do that. Because we manage our resources very well. We don't steal our resources. We are building a university, private university. The landmass is twice bigger than Imo State University. We don't make noise. If you are strong, you demonstrate it, not by talking on the internet. I'm telling Ohanaeze indeed. It's a challenge. If they can leave the governors funding them, if they can leave the governors funding them, Ohanaeze indeed, write your estimates for 1 year. Bin Masol will pay it 100%. Give a trial. Give a trial. If you can, you want to be independent as Ohanaeze Ndigbo, leave the governors. Because if the governors are sponsoring you, they will try to dictate for you, they'll try to control you, they'll try to influence you. If you can leave them, bring your budget year to year. The first year, 2021, bring Ohanaeze Ndigbo, bring your budget. If Bin Masol doesn't give you the budget 100%, you know that we are jokers. It's a challenge. So also, other pro-Biafra groups, whatever you are doing in your groups, if you can articulate whatever you are doing, Bin Masol will pay 50% of your programs to make sure that the struggle for Biafra goes on. Through non-violence anyway. I listen to those talking about unity of the pro-Biafra groups. Moreover, Chairman, for speaking against violence. Good. War can never achieve anything for Biafra. Now, you have to prepare for it. It's counterproductive. That's why I say I support them. And I say it again. Come up with your bill. We pay 100%. We don't need money from anybody, America, Britain. Money, how much will you say? How much do you have? We have been here for 20 years. We have that root. We have money. We are not just rich, we are wealthy. Because we use our resources well for the struggle only. You can say anything you want. The federal government is giving us little money. Blah, blah, blah. Let them give you your own money now. But I'm challenging everybody now, including the federal government. If you know you have given me one naira before, show. I challenge. I can't accept money from criminals. Politicians are criminals because they are corrupt. By being corrupt, you are a criminal. So I don't deal with criminals. So no governor can give me money. I accept because I'm not a poor man. I'm not a poor man. There are poor people that can take money from anywhere, anyhow they want because they are hungry. I'm not in that class because I function as a head of state. I've been there, so I cannot be a beggar. We help organizations who need help through non-violence. We don't sponsor criminal activities. I'm happy to talk to you today. I'm happy that today we are in 2021, and I'm happy to say and to tell you to continue whatever you are doing through non-violence. That's what matters. That's what matters. And as long as you are a non-violent freedom fighter.
Valeu, woman or get and wear away, Coro. If you could be an people, Ecolanda, did you call it? Did you call it? If you could be an opera, she will live if you're a Gibonania. Oye na 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 tabu gonya na nenu. Eno akayaka na akayaka. Iku pe bulu gone tike fono jinike. Eju na bane na na akayaka. Oko sisi chalu tele chegwa na go. Ibe ba kwa kama tala hori mine awaji ke nanya. Oko koko. Atu le kola gumwa. Tu veux qu'on m'a soigné?
Ah, pas toi, Yiji.
Dim, je crois que je suis un peu de jubu. Et si je suis un peu de jubu, je suis un peu de jubu. 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 Je suis un peu Ika na bogu nanya Onye le madu ojuku ijelebe Ikolo na bogi Obu nulak obu nong
Amu to yishi
Amu manegu igwe Ika na bali hizuwe ketegete Oyi na tumba Bulu bulu ojuku Ikolo na bogi Tunye Odi me gwondi ojuku Ewendu ewonu na gojuku Ike palo kwala egujide ndi loya Onye da onda gide wane ya Onye zina nyalu no mbogolo Yamano kono yukulu geme ife Ongo di me gojuku Yede kwa digi naru Oto kolo gyocho Dime me goni me gojuku Udas ru namba nya namba Obili dika kanana Ochubala dika ofia Amudi bunyi lenyi Imana dimbuli Ochubala lenyi zogu agunuku Obogu mwane Akwa miliaka Nadima nongu volu volu bonye Iwe biku mwibo Onyaga na wane ya Okwe jiri malo juku kwada kwada Uno makwano onyo kunyulu nakanya bunya funyulu ya Umu iwanyo gafu nyoko nyaga na wane ya Nibe vigo juku zanu nyaza
Mbasa
Kugolo na bukekwe na bodike neno wa Oboya na ndoma koya na u Omudike uru neno wa Ndino shindi nakwa Mane wadike no guno Mbasi ogo ama achola dike Mano ongo adilo nakwa dimegu ojuku Makanoru ni wafuli ananya
Mabwako ndivo
Asino ya mumadie muku no goda mulo ya Mano bura makemeko dimegu ojuku Onyike dimoko dimolo Wafuisi guru aranine Okala nyane jelo gwenyozi Ojuku Na bogu wane makwaru nyanisi Kamosi wane liye kanyabulu anu Asinu basamulu dike namba kamuli beya Mana dike nabamulu nopondo nopu ya kalini benya Makanizi nisi nabulu anu Namadu na kibeya
Akone
Ojuku sili kamumu ibaja mwangwelu gelu Kanya mchitelu mwibongu Maka namme wane membu mwibu Natanya kili kili nobi Ole ifu nanya kalili kaibu ndima
Mwere kwa
Nezi oku Azine nabi uwazo Uwa mwazo wa masa Aga mabuku onibo Mabulu wane mekodi megojuku Manongu manando Iko mambala yoku na ramwa akanaye bunde didu ne kupulu ganogi ojuku kemesia o
kemesia ikembandi kemesia
Oya mena nyani be Iyombia kojuku Azama mwani gebezina Ungulo dime kojuku Ndidi bogu wao Genare meko dime kojuku anaba o Ogu ni famu de nyeko nenu wa Omu wanye buteko Obuli boku na mwano juku kejido unaka
Kemesia
ikembandibu
kemesia
Obo jose bregele mubo
Kemesia ikembandibu
kemesia
Nowhere in London.
kole no nyo feze ze lo nyaka Ogwa kosine Owe buli fe kulu kanene nowa Kanje ze mu alanri Kanje ze mu nankeze ndelri The traditional ruler fu Mwi eshe kingdom His Royal Majesty, yes, and we will be the good. Oh, yes, so I'm not even when I'm mad. No, you're my little game. Me go, you got chicken ring. No, where's the big money? See, the money got the cash. My cash, I'm the aguacu. Ofobi, kandi ibo jaga. Ofobi, kandi ibo jaga. Noa. Isi namogo kisi nandi dapia. Isi ne titi webia o. Ani chabundi ibo. Buni fanyi danda Egwo na tori mili Okonye gado li mili Egwo na to Wele 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 Oh 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 Egwo na to kumanye kulu zondi mo Ezo kuna di mana
I remember even 2 months ago, I went somewhere after my performances. They start calling, oh, guess what? Oliver the Coke came here like yesterday. I said, yes, Oliver the Coke is dead. They said, no, he's not alive. He came to our place to perform. My name is Eugene Akanite alias Eugene the Cope, the younger brother, late Chief Oliver the Cope. Ojuku, my brother, he's from Newi, and now from Ezinifite, Newi South. I'm from Newi. So, Ojuku means a lot to me. Mostly, or not really me alone, but the whole world. That's why he passed. I said, okay, the best thing that I can do for Juku, I have no money to shower, push out there. I said, the best thing to do is to do this tribute to him. Yeah. I think I was at age of probably 4 or 5 years old during the Civil War. So I had a lot of Biafran War. I knew a little about Biafran War. And it's like, when you mention Ojuku like this, it's like, wow, where is he? You know, he used to be one of the greatest. And also a hero, you know. So I know much about Ojuku from my childhood. You know, my dad, Julius Akanite, his beard was just like this. So we look like our dad. It's not fake, it's original. Look at it. If you want to draw it, you can touch it, you know. It's not fake. I feel like, you know, to just leave it this way. Let Oliver the Cope do have the same beard as that of my dad. You know, I play the guitar for the brand. I play the guitar. Abada, Messiah, Ikohaba, People's Cup of Nigeria, Identity, Opportunity, name all that records. I played all the guitars. I started music at age of 11. Then 1976, we formed Expo 76, Ogene Sound Super. Then I played lead when Oliver played solo. So the first record was Messiah, Ewozamo. I played the guitar. From there, Nazo, Abada, Moloyone, Ekwesi, and so on. So I've been playing guitar since 1972, at the age of 11. Yes, I played when Oliver taught me. By the way, he taught me how to play this guitar. He taught me how to play solo. Then called a guy called Piccolo, all the way from Congo. Because he was telling me that, he said, one day I will form my own band. Then I would like you to be the lead guitarist, and I wanted to play guitar even more than me. So he taught me how to play solo. After that, he brought a Congolese called a piccolo. Piccolo taught me how to play lead guitar. Then 1976, then he formed Expo 76. From there, I joined his band. But I was playing with the musicians back then. Played with King Joseph Friday, yes. Sonia there. I played with other musicians. After that, then we found Expo 76. From there, we continue. From 1976 to 1987, we traveled to United States of America. 1984, after 5 months of tour, we came back to Nigeria. Then 1986 again, we traveled to America again. We toured for 4 months again, we came back to Nigeria. Then 1987, we traveled back to America again. That was when I decided to, so I tell my brother, you know what, I would like to stay here in America. I want to learn how to play jazz music, this and that, and go back to school and do this. Then he said, it's okay. Then I dropped over to New York, from New York to California. I've been in California since 1988 to 2010. Then I came back to bury my senior brother. Then after that, it's okay. It doesn't make sense for me to go back to America again. Then the best thing is for me to stay here and keep the flag flying, you know. You go to America, you ask about Eugene Dicob, East Coast, West Coast, you know, I performed over there. I'm so popular over there. You know, my intention then was to play kind of pop music or jazz music. But one day at Air Communal College, they called me to come and, you know, rehearse with them. I went there, I was just tuning my guitar. Then I started playing African rhythm. Wow, everybody was just, oh, well. From there, I formed Igede Band. That was 1992. From there, I started playing African music. I made 4 albums over there in the United States of America. And the last one I did was Shokolo, Shokolo music, before coming back to Nigeria. About 4, I did Tribute, Oliver's Tribute, which is Ijowa. After Ijowa, Eugene Abiago, that's a club called Ndibo, over there in California. Igbo Cultural Association, yeah. I made a CD. Then after that one, yeah, no Ojukwu, making 4,
yeah,
with Ibidan Studio, and it was good. Yeah, I love Ojukwu CD so much because I think the rhythm is so fantastic. I love the music. Playing it on stage like this, I can see bumps on my arms. I love Ojukwu. It makes me to remember Ojukwu. And the other second track, Ife's Rezo Gapotife. And the last track called Do Good. Do Good was, we composed that music 1975 with my late brother Oliver Dicob. It was recorded 1982, if I'm not mistaken. But the record, when did we know, it was kind of so. So I said, okay, the best to do is to change the rhythm a little bit and replay the Do Good. You know, like the Bible says, whatever you reap, whatever you sow, you're going to reap whatever you sow, shall reap it. So that's why I said, okay, let me do that because I like the concept, you know. You do good, you got good, you do bad, then you reap bad, some of that. You know?
Ife zere zoga
put it fair.
Even
the Zoga put it
fair.
Even the Zoga put it
fair.
Even the Zoga put it
fair.
Even the Zoga put it fair. Even the Zoga put it fair. Even the Zoga put it fair. Even the Zoga put it fair. Even the Zoga put it fair. Even the Zoga put it fair. Even Mancha King Yishindu Kokwe Nandia Gumu Anike Necheje Nabata Bata Aja Mwa Soli Kuku Biomese Soli Kuku Nabano Onwe Gwa Jango Onwe Ya
Onwe Gwa Onwe Ya Onwe Gwa Jango Onwe Ya Onwe Gwa Nabali Beku
Onwe Gwa Jango Onwe Ya
Onwe Gwa Onwe Ya Onwe Gwa Jango Onwe Ya
Ebuzima, ibadima, onya bona bali beku.
Thank you.
la coupe.
Oh, mais y'a quoi?
Even in Jordan, y'en a noa. A commande, y'en a noa. Y'en a namba namba. Was is he one of the no, when a dicken a number, he can have for. If I see can if I got one,
Bawa, Oga, I can hear the name. Bawa, 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 we face the link. Bawa, 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 we face the link. Bawa, 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 we face the link. Bawa, 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 we face the link.
Oh yeah, it's good.
A lot of people have said a lot about you, Ojukwu, and your activities. They seem to liken your activities to the activities of Ojukwu when he was young, before the Biafra war. Yeah. How do you see that?
I leave that to them, and I think by a large extent they are right. You know, because I studied Ojukwu, you know, through the books while I was young, and read about all he did. That was why when I went to the secondary school, I started thinking about him, and eventually I stumbled onto an Kaimbia through nonviolence. So I felt that nonviolence would be the appropriate mechanism to achieve the subject of the army. And he was a military officer. Mine, you know, being a student of Gandhi, and adopted my own system.
That Ojukwu never supported myself at the beginning. But later, he brought you in, and it was in fact your father, I say, was in fact your advisor. Was in fact almost everything that I gave you the encouragement. How did you meet Ojukwu for the first time?
It's a very long story, you know, but the fact is that before I found myself, I had worked with him for close to 10 years. I mean, one-on-one. So, you know, I was working with him. I actually wanted to introduce the issue of Biafra, or rather, reintroduce the issue of Biafra by so many means. I realized that law was to be studied at a second degree. So I had to begin a study in political science where I had other opportunity to study non-violence movement and Mahatma Gandhi himself. So I started everything in Nigeria.
Okay, studied in Nigeria. You studied political science. Does that mean that you dropped law?
No. No. In India, before professional courses like law and medicine are done at undergraduate level. So I studied political science as a first degree, which qualifies me to read law. I started law afresh on the first year as a field, because in India you can't study law as a first degree. You must have the first degree in any of the social sciences before you are permitted to read law.
You lost the ambition to form Masov in India, or the notion came to you when you arrived in India?
I can say that the notion was circumstantial in the sense that when I was in India, I wasn't really thinking about a revolution per se. I just went to India to understand Mahatma Gandhi and see a way Biafra could be actualized through non-violence. You understand me? So I didn't have any notion about Masov or any other organization. But after Masov was circumstantial because of the violent circumstances at that particular time, regarding Obasanjo's administration.
When you say the violent circumstances, there might be something that triggered your mind.
Yes, so that's what I'm saying. You know, when I came into Nigeria and went to the law school and all that, was called to bar, then, this guy died, Sani Abacha died, and Absalami Abubakar came on board. Then Absalami lifted the ban on politics. Then Obasanjo was in detention. So it came up that the Yoruba had to produce the president, where Olufolaye and Obasanjo. It happened that Ohanaeze Ndigbo was that Ndigbo should support Obasanjo, because I heard that Obasanjo, being a general and a retired general, and given the circumstance of his detention and release, that he would have had a lot of experience, you know, that would make him a better statesman to govern Nigeria. So I supported Obasanjo. and was able to convince the youth that Obasanjo would make a better president. So after the election, you know, Obasanjo, we expected a lot from his administration. So, but what actually he did was disappointing to me, because among the 12 Security Council members, because constitutionally, two Security Council members were supposed to come from each geographical zone, but he picked from all the geographical zones and didn't pick anyone from the southeast. But he picked four from the southwest, is Yoruba area. And when people started criticizing him, he was asked why he did so. He said, one, that there was no major general from the southeast. He was reminded that even during his regime, after Murtala Mohammed died, that Sheikh Musa Yar'Adua was promoted from a colonel to major general to be his second in command. So he had a lot of, you know, someone that is often temperamental. So he said, as for the people defeated in the war, are not supposed to talk for the next 200 years. So that angered me personally. I said that the issue of the Afro-Nigeria war has gone, and that for anybody to make reference to it is, you know, to protest. I felt, okay, since he's making reference to the same issue, that the other issue should continue. So that was what motivated me at that particular time to form myself. So that was why I said it was second solution. I had wanted to use evil organizations to start the foundation of that. You know, so it was through this issue of people organizations that brought me closer to Jubu. You know, because I was the chairman of Jubu Council of Chiefs, Lagos State.
That was what year?
1994, 95, 96. Around that time, I was the chairman. So my idea was to get all Igbo organizations in Lagos under the Council of Chiefs, which I did. You know, I was instrumental to the formation of Ezendigbo Lagos. As a matter of fact, I constituted Ezendigbo Lagos, you know, and the Igbo speaking space in Lagos. I formed all these things and asked people to man them. But I was advising, I wanted to use that, all these organizations, to showcase Biafra again. But it didn't work out because most of the people we are afraid. They didn't even want, you know, due to this, that nobody there mentioned the word Biafra. At that time, it was a big, big taboo. So the people I needed the idea to run away. So I decided to form myself. So it was when I was the chairman of People Council of Chiefs that I met Ojukwu. Actually, the issue was that, first, so many issues came in. When he was declared Ezigbo Bunguru, you know, Ohaneze kicked against him by buying up all the media house, you know, newspaper houses to denounce him. So I wasn't in support of what Ohaneze was doing. So I called press conferences supporting Ojukwu. By then I didn't know anything about, I didn't know Ojukwu, I hadn't met him the first time. But he was reading most of the things I was saying in the papers. Moreover, there was this Post Express Lagos, you know, by Sonny Odeku, who was a publisher, so the paper had propagated my views about him. So, but what actually made me meet Ojukwu the first time was when there was crisis in Lagos, arising from Abiola's debacle, you know, because when Abiola was denied the presidency stuff, you know, the Yorubas revolted, there was killing in Lagos and all that. So in the morning, woke up in the streets, you see non-indigenous being killed and all that. So I called a meeting of non-indigenous in Lagos, comprising Igbos, Hausas, Igbos, all these other people that were not Yorubas. So we met, and in that meeting we resolved that we should approach two prominent Nigerians, that's one from the Igbo, one from Hausa, to meet General Marwa. That time was a big guy, Colonel, to tell him about the unsafe situation or the security issue surrounding non-indigenous in Lagos. Also, PC was killing non-indigenous arbitrarily. So we selected Ojukwu and N.D. Hamza, the businessman, because he was living in Apapa then. So it was, we decided to meet Ojukwu first. So I went to Ojukwu's residence at Queen's Drive and dropped the letter, telling us our intentions. So then Ojukwu was in Enugu, but because of that, he flew down to Lagos. You know, he told his PA, Bob Onyema, that anytime he came to Lagos, he would get in touch with us. So when he came, Bob phoned us to say Ojukwu was around. So all the non-indigenous, the leaders comprising Igbos and Hausas and other interest groups kind of, to, in my house, you know, we went to Alaska Lodge, Igbo UP. So it was the third time Ojukwu could see me, but he was reading all I was saying about him. So after the meeting, he accepted to meet all on our behalf and other. So after the meeting, he helped me and asked me to stay behind. So I stayed behind. It was then that he asked me to come back the next day and talk with him. So after we had gone, the next day I came back and we sat and discussed that phase of Ndigo. So from there he saw, you know, the burning desire to work on Ndigo in me. So I became so not only Marwa, I started taking the prominent Nigerians, you know, from Toby Williams to this big people. Even when Abacha died, I went with him to others from Marwa. We became very close, and so when the issue, I decided to form myself. The opinion of the people was that it was Ojukwu's idea, because they knew I was very close to him. Times he asked me to, he wanted to say anything. The leader asked me to say it to the leader. I would call a press conference and say, this is Ojukwu's position on this. I was doing it, and the people saw me as his, you know, his, you know, media person. So when I started myself, it was very difficult for people to say that people didn't know about it. And unfortunately, they didn't know about it. Papa was in the United States when I did that Biafra in Abba, and he read it like every other person. And he felt betrayed, the sense that I was supposed to let him, but I didn't let him. And when later, you know, because actually, when people said it precisely, he did. Because he was right to do that, because I didn't tell him. And all the prominent Nigerians had seen me with him, either in public places or, you know, visiting them, you know. So it was like, is it not that young man who came with Ojukwu the other day in this place and that place? So he was disappointed. So, you know, at that time, you know, the Obasanjo invited him and also Carlo when I declared the father. So he said that it was him father. You know, that was the logic. Because he didn't tell him. But later when he called me back, he asked me the reason why I didn't tell him. I told him that I didn't. Because if I had told him, he would say no, don't do it. And I would have stopped. All I did was stop. Because I wouldn't disappoint, I wouldn't disobey. That was what I told the product. It was the product he manufactured. So, and for the love he had for Biafra, it was impossible for him to petition anybody that was to continue with that episode. So he brought me a
wonderful night. You were conspicuously absent. A lot of people worried.
It was planned, you know, it was an agreement I entered with Jonathan at Masoro. Because, you know, before it was forget the Senate. The motion was Deborah at the Senate, and they said you could also receive the state letter, you know, giving their reasons. So they had already dropped the idea. But later, we had a discussion. Jonathan intervened and, you know, because when they threw away the motion, we got the fact to bury Ojukwu. You know, I had even concluded arrangements to, you know, I had even made commitments and all that. For 7 days, I've carried the body to the different states. When Jonathan realized all this, so he talked, he said that he wants to come in, or he wanted to come in, and that he wanted Ojukwu to be doing a national burial, and that was what I really wanted. You know, he said there's no way he could shy from us all. Like he wanted me to appear with him. So we had so many discussions. At the point, both the Chief of Army Staff, Olenji, and others were involved. You know, so we agreed that Ojukwu could receive the national burial that Masop should play in the ceremony. We agreed. It was an agreement. The only person that knew about it was Jim Kai's wife. All these people, they are not part of it. They didn't even know the witness were ahead. So, but Jonathan knows the people who we are supposed to know, knew about it. So I know people will be disappointed, but then I achieved my purpose to give Ojukwu the biggest burial on earth. Because I said it, you know, in his house, at the end of when I was receiving visitors there, I said that Ojukwu will receive, his burial will be the best in Africa. But at the end of the day, it became the best in the whole world. I can tell you authoritatively that outside Jesus Christ, I've not seen anybody's burial as big as that of Ojukwu. I started to challenge it. So I got more than even I thought I could get. I wanted to be a monumental success. And when I saw Jonathan coming, I withdrew, because I had achieved what I wanted.
But Ojukwu is beyond the rating. Yes. When you talk about an icon, people like Ojukwu come once in a while in history. And it's like saying, how do you rate great men of society over the years? A visionary. As you say, a man who even came before his time. What is happening in this country to the world? What Ojukwu foresaw by 30, 40 years, 50 years ago? And all his pictures have come to pass. And more importantly, all those people who did not celebrate 30, 40 years ago have come to realize that Ojukwu represented massive symbolic, because from where it comes from, Ngri is the ancient kingdom of the Jaiboris. And if you have studied various research works, and anybody that has received the offer from the Ezengri has received their spiritual and physical authority to be the leader of Ndibo. And this is not just peculiar to us. The Yoruba race, you have the Ife, you know, the Ife dynasty. If you are that's from where they draw their strength. For the Muslim draw from the caliphate. We must have something. We have something. And it is good that Igbos have come to realize that we must go back to recreate our past. When people say Igbo Enwe Eze, I laugh, because that's a saying that is derived from ignorance. Because where, if Igbo Enwe Eze, where did the word Eze emanate from the first instance? Igbo Enwe Eze. That's why we say Igbo Ohane Eze. It's just that the Igbo Eze, the Igbo king, is not as autocratic as other kings. He rules with the people. So for Ezengri to appreciate the role Wazirike has played, let us not miss the fact. But for Wazirike's leadership today, even the support and strength he gave to Ikemba, the Igbo race would have been far back behind than we are today, even though we have not made much progress. But his struggle, his determination to fight for the Igbo race has in a long way, more than any other effort made by any other organization, has come to position the Igbo people as a formidable force, which we are in the current Nigeria. So I encourage our brother not to be distracted. I encourage the younger generation to accept that we must attend God. Provides leadership. Nature abhors vacuum. The ethic of our leader is the deal with Mobutu should not leave us a leaderless. In any case, who else is there to lead? Everybody has checked out. Is it our government officials? We must have a leadership that is honest, determined, and committed, and courageous to confront challenges faced as
my commander during the war. I fought them the Ujuku in Biafra. And the people take Ujuku that time as a demigod. Ujuku was being seen as above human being. Whatever Ujuku says, it happens in the next 1 minute. What Ujuku saw about 50 years ago, we are seeing it now. So Ujuku cannot be described as an icon. Ujuku is above icon.
Recently, you were at Inri during the confinement of Igiel Ndigbo on Rafa Wazirike. Do you think it's proper to have given Rafa Wazirike such an honor?
When I learned that the Ezeiri, the Ashen Kingdom, will be given Wazirike for funding to replace Ojukwu, I thought that was a joke. I decided to make sure that I was present at that occasion. And I left here and got there with my camera. I recorded it and I was very happy to be part of that ceremony. Number one, Wazirike, the risk he has taken in life, I don't think there is anybody who has taken such risk after Ujuku. This is the only place. When he started, my thinking that time was that also they will kill this man, Nigerians, what is going on in Nigeria. This man was talking just like as Ujuku was vehemently talking about Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo-Ibo
ndị okenye were kpọọ ndị obodo ya were gwa ha chaa mbọ ịhụrụ opi m ụzọ mere zazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazazaz